Hey guys, it's Emily. Welcome to Posie Lane. So whenever I'm looking for inspiration for like the next craft for a video, I kind of look at things that I'm seeing around me and try to notice different things. And this past week, I started seeing sunflowers everywhere. I went to the grocery store and they had some potted that you could plant out front. And then I went on a date night at a restaurant with my husband and a woman was wearing a full like sunflower dress. Then I was going to look at pop sockets with my daughter and they had a really cute sunflower one. And then I noticed an article in the news about how you could go cut your own sunflowers in this field, which sounds really fun, but I haven't done it. And then I started seeing them on someone's door and it just got me thinking about how I could really do something with sunflowers that would be great for like summer and be really summery, but also could transition into fall. And I'm always looking for an idea for something that would last longer than just like a couple months, that would maybe stretch into multiple seasons. And so I was thinking about how just great and vibrant they are and happy for summer, but then they're also like warm tones that would be great for fall. And so I decided that I'm gonna try to make a wreath with them and see how it goes. For me, the most important part of the wreath is the form, like the base of what we're going to be making. And I wanted something that looked natural because I'm not going to put flowers all over it. If I got like a foam one or a wire one, it's going to be more expensive in buying flowers than it would just to put a few on the side and have something, spend a little bit more on that form. And this was $6 at Hobby Lobby. One thing about Hobby Lobby and one thing about me is I don't like paying full price for anything. I'm not cheap, I'm just frugal, okay? And so I always wait for those sales to rotate and for what I'm buying to be on sale before I'll buy it. And so all the florals, not the fall stuff, but all the florals were on sale when I went for 50% off. So I got this bush for $5. And when I get flowers for outside, I don't want them to be the nicest ones they have because it's gonna be out in the rain and it's gonna get faded by the sun and like bugs are gonna be on it. So I usually try to go like middle of the road because I don't want it to be the cheapest thing either when it's the main flower. I also got this green, which I love all the tiny little flowers on it for only $4 because it was half off. Then to add some flowers later so it looks a little bit more fall, I got these at the dollar store and they don't have to be as realistic looking because it's not the main flower. To put it all together, I've got wire and a hot glue gun. Just make sure it stays all in place. And then I also have wire cutters to cut up the bush and the wire. And that's all you need. I love buying a bush because one, it's cheaper. If you buy single stems of things, you're gonna be paying like way more. It's gonna be like $4 or $5 for each one instead of $5 for a whole entire bush. The other thing is whenever I use a bush, I do not leave it intact. I used to work at a flower shop and people would come in with these like horror, like please rescue my attempt at an arrangement. And they would literally have just like whole like bushes just like stuck in there and then they would spread it out. And they were like, what did I do wrong? And it's like, well, first off, you wanna cut up your bush and like spread it out. You don't want it all attached to each other. So I always cut it up. And the other thing with the greenery, sometimes we notice like I can cut up the stems or I can also just rip off a section and then I have a little section if I'm wanting to spread it around. So never feel like you have to do it a certain way. Try to think outside the box when you're putting flowers together. Let's start cutting the flowers and placing them on the wreath. For cutting them, my theory is always you can cut something too long and recut it, but if you cut it too short, you just may be like lost on it. You may not be able to fix it. So I'm gonna make them a little bit longer than I need. So, and then kind of feel it out, I guess, and see where they need to go, and I can always trim them. If you don't have wire cutters, I found that you can use like a strong pair of scissors and kind of cut it around and then wiggle it until the wire snaps. And that usually works just as well. now we've got everything cut and we can start placing it. When I do placement, I like to put my green down first. Whenever I did like floral arrangements at the flower shop, we would say that we're making a bush first. So I want it all greened out and then I'm going to put the other things on top. Now that we've got everything cut, let's start placing it on the wreath. I like to sketch out what I'm going to make before I actually start. It helps me get it out of my mind. Usually I have a picture of what I want it to look like, and just seeing it on paper helps me visualize it a lot better. And with this, I kind of have two ideas. The first one is to do it where all the flowers are at the top, kind of like a swag. And so I'm just gonna use basic shapes. It doesn't have to be too detailed, just to kind of get the picture of what I want it to look like. And for it, I'm gonna start with a bigger bloom in the middle, and then I'm gonna work my way out, kind of doing it a little bit symmetrical, where I'll do one bloom here and one bloom there, and just see how it looks. My other idea is to do the wreath asymmetrical. And what I mean by that is that I'm gonna put all of the flowers just on one side. I'm gonna do basic shapes again, and I'm gonna start kind of at the bottom and then do bigger blooms first and then fill it in with the smaller blooms and just see what I think about it. I'm going to try a couple of the ideas that I sketched because I really want to see it now in real life. I'm going to try with it at the top and doing like a swag, and then I'm also going to try where it's on the side and it looks more asymmetrical. I like the idea of just doing it either one place or the other, because that way I don't have to cover the whole entire wreath with flowers, and it'll help save me money and stay in my budget. A couple tips when you're doing arrangements is, first, you always want to place the green down. For me, when I worked at a flower shop, I always thought about it like making a bush. You want to make it look really full and kind of like a bush. And then you can put the blooms down. Whenever you do blooms, you want to do things kind of in odd numbers. It tends to look better. And also, you want varying sizes. If you think about nature, things aren't all the same size. It's not uniform. And so you want it to kind of mimic that and not look too uniform. I was going to take everything off the wreath and then put it back again where it looks asymmetrical. But then when I thought about it, I realized that all I had to do was shift the wreath and all the flowers were already on the side and I didn't have to take them all off. And when I look at it from the side, I think I like that a little bit more than on the top. And I think that's what I'm gonna go with, is the asymmetrical look. Which one did you like better? It's time to attach everything and make it more permanent. And when you think about the fact that this is going to go outside, there's going to be wind and there's going to be other weather that can make things fall off. So I really want to make sure that it's good and tight on there. So I'm going to use wire and I'm going to use hot glue. For the wire, I'm using 26 gauge wire, and I like it because it's pliable and it will be easy to bend and twist around, and it's also easy to cut. And so that will be easy to use. Also, I'm going to use hot glue. And with the hot glue, I'm just using the low temp setting because I think for the florals, we don't really need that high temp setting. And hopefully it will stay on. Whenever I'm using hot glue, I always like to have a small bowl of cold water around just in case I burn myself. I can put my hand in there and it gives some quick relief. Hot glue can be very hot. When I was a kid, we had this one that was made of metal, and the whole thing was like surface of the sun hot. So I learned back then, you want to have something cold that you can put your hands in just in case. I'm cutting the wire off as I go, and that way I don't have to keep track of where all the wire is. And I'm just cutting off a little bit at a time because I don't need a lot to attach each stem. I'm going to start at the bottom and then work my way up to the top. And I'm going to start with the base layer, which is the greenery, and then add the blooms as I go. And with the greenery, you just want to attach the wire to the greenery, and then you're going to attach it to the wreath. Then with the excess, you kind of twist tie it like you would a sandwich tie and cut off the excess. Then you'll add the blooms and attach them. Once everything is attached where you like it in that section, I'm going to hot glue a little bit, and then I'll move on and work my way up in sections until everything is secure, everything's tightened down, and everything's hot glued. As I went, I found that it was actually easier if I took the whole stem off and wrapped the green wire around it, and then I attached it with the wire to the wreath. And I wish I had noticed this at first, but at least I did figure it out, and it went a lot quicker once I did. One of the perks of using fake flowers is that the stems can be adjusted, they are wire, and they can be moved and bent to look the way you want them, or maybe to move them where you see that it's kind of looking like it needs it over there, or there's like a bald spot, or it's looking bare. And you know, if you had a real flower, you can't bend it. It's gonna break the stem. So that's why I love working with silk flowers. This wreath costs less than $20 to make. I don't know if I mentioned that earlier. I think I forgot. And I think it looks so pretty. If you've gone to the store, there's wreaths that are like 60, 70 bucks. And yeah, they're pretty, but I don't have that in my budget. So I'm really glad that I was able to make this for less than 20. This wreath looks really pretty as is. I love all the sunflowers on it, but I want to take it a step further and make it look a little bit more like fall by adding some pops of color here or there. And I'm going to do that by using these blooms that I had found at the dollar store. And I'm just going to cut them off and add them, you know, in different places where maybe there's more greenery and there's not as much sunflowers. I'm cutting the stems kind of short because I'm just going to add these with some wire here or there in the arrangement. And I noticed that when I was cutting it, I needed to move the leaves up before I cut it, or I was just going to cut the leaves off and they weren't going to be part of the wreath. I didn't end up using all of the blooms that I had, and so I actually made a bud vase with them, with a vase that I had gotten at the thrift store. And I just added the three biggest blooms first because that's going to be the center of the arrangement, and then I used some leftover leaves from the sunflower and used them in the back to prop it up to help hold up those bigger blooms. And then I just used a little filler, smaller flowers and smaller greenery just to fill in and make it look even more full and even more pretty. What is your favorite season? My favorite season is fall. There's just something about when the air starts to get cool and crisp, and you want to drink a pumpkin spice latte because, yes, I am basic. I love pumpkin spice lattes. And starting to wear warmer clothes like sweaters and getting to see all the leaves change. And my favorite part is crunching all the leaves under my feet. I just love all of those things. And that's why fall is my favorite season. This looks so awesome. It's amazing. When I see sunflowers, I can't not smile. So I'm going to make sure to put this on the door that goes to the porch for my living room so I can see it all the time, because I think it's just gonna put a smile on my face every time I see it. And when I hang up a wreath, I use an over the door hanger so I don't mess up my door. And also I have a glass door, so it's not like I can really put a nail through it. So I found like an over the head thing, over the door hanger for 70% off one time after Christmas. And so I just use that, but you could also use like a command hook to hang it up. And I love how these flowers just look like a bright pop for fall. But if I wanted this more, like put this out in July or in August, I only attach them with a wire and I can snip the wire and it will look more summery, and then I'll save them to the side and add them back again. Thank you guys so much for watching. I can't wait for what we're gonna make next week.